Good evening, hockey fans, and welcome to the Houston Fieldhouse for tonight's non-league game. It's the Terriers of Boston University taking on your RPI engineers here on RPI TV and ESPN Plus. Perry Lascaris high above the action here in the press box. It's the 3-0-2 Terriers, 3-0-2 in hockey East play. This is their first non-league game. Taking on the 2-4-0 RPI engineers, RPI 2-0 in the conference. They last played 2 weeks ago. BU played last weekend. A single game on Friday at home against Merrimack, which they tied 4-4. In fact, they're coming off back-to-back ties. They also tied New Hampshire back on Saturday, the 9th, up in New Hampshire, 3-3. This is a series that had some decent amount of history to it. Teams first met in 05-06 twice here at the Houston Fieldhouse. RPI took the first two games of the all-time series, 7-3 and 5-3. It's been a very close series ever since, with BU winning at home and RPI winning at home as well. So it's been been a while, though, since these two teams met. The 13-14 season was the last time they played. It was a 2-2 tie here in Troy. And a different look, of course, on both sides here. None of those players involved. It'll be BU in the red with the white sleeves there with the puck along the far side boards. Julian Neeris back to the point as they work it quickly to the near side, but shot was blocked. Second try also blocked as Mara Wagner got in the way of that one. RPI gets it to center and dumps it in. Second line starting for the engineers, Rihanna Janke out there with Mara Wagner, Lauren Severson. Backing up now is Andy Calderoni. It'll be chipped up off the boards. They wave off the icing, so the RPI has to go track it down. Taylor Larson, sophomore from Bolton, Ontario, will get there. Now McKenna Parker. Work back to the point. Shot comes in, save made, kick to the corner. First stop of the game. First shot of the game goes to BU. First stop for Amanda Rompato. Picked up her first two collegiate wins 2 weeks ago against Union. After starting her career 0-15. Here's Larson throwing it down the middle off the stick of Maddie Papineau. We haven't seen her in a few weeks. She's only played two games so far this year. Now a chance for BU to break into the zone. Donnelly flipping it in front, comes all the way through the crease. Work back to the blue line. Shot comes in by Shaughnessy, that's blocked. Kicked out to center by Papineau. She'll try and jump on it here. Cutting across to break things up is Ellie Larson for BU. And Larson will track it down behind her own goal. Kaylee Donnelly, senior from Wellesley, Mass. One assist in five games this year. Gets it as far as center, where it's wrapped back towards the RPI bench. Pinned up there, Audrey McCutcheon, the ECAC Rookie of the Week 2 weeks ago. She had four goals, including a hat trick against Union. As a shot comes in, stopped by Rompato with that right pad, as she denied Fulem, sophomore from New Brunswick. And we got a faceoff coming up in the RPI zone. Face-off won by RPI, sent it behind the goal. Tegan Dalby had her pass partially blocked, but Freese Hansen's able to swat it out to center. Now backing up is Dalby, shoots it off the wall. Collected there by Nadia Mativi, junior out of Italy, plays for the Italian national team. Mativi can't keep that one, a chance for RPI to break here. Thrown across towards the far side and just couldn't handle the pass. It was, backhanded in front by McCutcheon. Mativi. Pressured there by Ellie Kaiser for RPI. Sophomore from Westmont, Illinois. Puck finally out to center. BU in all alone. It's Lacey Martin. The defenseman, Calderoni, just holding things up in the offensive zone while her teammates change behind her. Now Larson trying to poke it along. It's broken up there. Courtney Correa in deep. Top point getter for this BU team. 5'6" out of Whitby, Ontario. Cycling now are the Terriers. Thrown into the middle, and good job to tie up sticks there. It was looking for Kylie Roberts, the freshman from Edina, Minnesota. She couldn't find the puck. Now a shot comes in. It goes wide from Janky. As Rihanna Janky is the lone Janky sister in the lineup tonight. No Mika. Breaking ahead now are the Terriers. McKenna Parker will cycle deep. Nobody home. Picked up by Delaney Weiss. She gave it away. Brooks Ursoy in the corner. Couldn't keep it alive. And now back to center comes RPI. Lauren Severson. Handed off to Janky. Penalty coming up here on BU. And it's going to be a slash at 15:37. Or with 15:37 left in the first period. First power play of the game for RPI. They come in at 13.3%, 2 out of 15. Penalty kill for the Terriers, 77.8. That's 7 out of 9. Shot comes in. That was blocked, and it's back out to center. Papineau trying to dig for it now with Donnelly right on her. And now Erbinova. Now, Mara Wagner spins away from a stick check and works it back to Severson. She can't handle the pass. Picked up by Janky, who tried to stick handle. That's broken up as well and cleared all the way down. Quick change here for the Terriers. Erbinova, half fanned on the pass, but gets it ahead. And Larson gets it deep. Overskated behind the goal by Cardesi. Now back to the point where it's kept in. Julia Blitz working that left point, a forward. RPI with just one defenseman on this power play unit. That is Taylor Larson. And it's Larson to pick it up behind the goal. 44 to go in the first man advantage of the game for either team. And it's flipped in there and then sent out. Capel couldn't corral. Larson with pressure spins away from that. As Parker put the press on. Now here's Blitz throwing it down low. It'll wrap around. Capel now tied up in the corner. Correa trying to dig it out of some skates. Now there's three engineers over there. Worked back to the point. 11 to go on the power play. Sent across. One-timer Blitz and hit a body in front and went wide. Julia Blitz got into one. It might have been headed wide anyway, but it hit a body. Back out to center it comes. As it'll be worked behind the cage. Chipped off the wall and now moved on further by Peterson. We got another penalty coming up here. It's going to be on the engineers, I think. They're calling a trip. So to the box is Naya Phillip for RPI, sophomore from Mississauga, Ontario. So the first power play for BU comes up now. 22.2% on the year. That's 4 out of 18. It's a pretty good number if they can keep that at that rate. Cardesi onto the tape of Ursoy. Move it back up top. Good stick there by Buckvik. And RPI eventually clears. Engineers on the penalty kill this year, 91.3%, 21 of 23. So strength versus strength early in the year. You can't put too much stock into percentages early, but converting surely helps and on both ends of things. Terriers work it down low. Ursoy, junior from Arlington Heights, Illinois. Got a few former Chicago Mission out there on both sides. There's a wrist shot coming. Save made by Rampato. No rebound. Ursoy was looking for one. It didn't come. Face-off win here for the Terriers. Calderoni dumps it in the corner. Dalby tied up there. Calderoni again. Donnelly back to Calderoni. And the shot comes in. That was blocked. And Severson's going to try to clear. It was played with a high stick, and this will only benefit RPI. They might as well go ahead and touch this thing. Just wasting their own power play time if they don't. Good hand-eye there, but I guess it's kind of 6-1, half a dozen the other, because it's going to be the puck's going to head back to your own end of the ice anyway. You might as well get a touch on it. It was dumped that way. 38 seconds to go on the power play. And the penalty to Phillip. Now Donnelly. Out of the corner, back to the point. Calderoni shoots it in wide. Picked up by Parker. 6 points on the year for McKenna Parker, senior from Clavitt, Saskatchewan. There's a long shot, hits a body, and it comes trickling in on Rampato, who gives the tap to the shin pad of MJ Alexander. Four seconds remain on the power play. Right off the draw, it shot through. Back to the blue line, out of the box. Centineers kill it off. And it's flipped wide in the end by Haley Blinkhorn, junior out of Oakdale, Minnesota. Shot wide from the point by Grace Parker. Engineers behind their own net, and McCutcheon, it was a little bit of stick handling there and nearly ran into trouble. RPI now able to break the center. One-handed up the wall by Hannah Price and turned around by the Terriers. Some room to work on the far side. Madison Michaels. And there's going to be a penalty here on Larson, it looks like. What are they going to call it? Interference? Oh, boy. I mean, Michaels had the puck. I'd like to see that again. 10:32 to play in the first. I don't know. It looked like she was making a play on the puck. That's a good work by our RPI TV crew. But it is another penalty. Officials today, I forgot to get to those. Anthony DiPuzzo, Michael St. Lawrence are the refs. Linesman Lawrence Krugliak and Scott Steinell. But back-to-back power plays here for BU. And there's a puck tipped in on goal and a save. Redirection by Parker. Point blank, and now Donnelly. Calderoni across. Wrist shot coming in. That one might have caught a piece of Rampato on the shot from the far side by Mativi. Now another shot in and a save by Amanda Rampato. She was the MAC goaltending goalie of the week in ECAC hockey after their RPI's opening weekend, despite the fact that RPI went 0-2. She kept RPI in a couple of real tight games out at Mercyhurst in their opening regular season week. Back to the point, Julia Shaughnessy. Hands it off to Ursoy. And now back up top. Poked at by Weiss, couldn't corral. Trying to walk the goal line was Neeris. She's turned away. Long shot blocked by Capel. The effort was from Shaughnessy. Couple of players spill in the corner. Everybody's back up. Ursoy has it, 47 to go in the power play. MJ Alexander separates her from the puck. BU keeps it alive, back to the point. Shaughnessy gets it back, and a little give and go when she put it wide. Back up top it goes. Cardacy hands that one off to Fulham. Now Shaughnessy. Behind the goal, Ursoy. Back to the point. BU making a partial change on this power play, keeping the puck in the offensive zone. 12 to go. Wraparound try thrown through the crease. Back out to the blue line it comes, Shaughnessy. Back down low. Wuthrich. Shaughnessy, a wrist shot off the post! Oh, what an opportunity there for BU. As Rampato was screened, she couldn't see it. It just rang off the near iron. Back comes Donnelly. Two on two, a wrist shot that skims along the ice and wide. Now another shot turned away by Rampato on the try by Mativi. As a defenseman joined the play there. It's been a barrage here for the Terriers in this first period, helped out by a pair of power plays. But Rampato has stood tall so far. 7:48 to go in the period. Delaney Weiss. RPI just trying to find their way out of the zone. They finally tip it to center. Severson gets a touch on it. Mativi back to get it. Thrown behind by Korea. And now Parker. Trying to stick handle through some sticks was Korea. That was forced to the outside. Parker to the point. Wrist shot coming. Save made. Rampato. Rebound fell to the side of the cage. Got some help from Price. And now Severson has a chance to look up ice. She'll flip it along out to center, swatted all the way down. And this will, yeah, we'll call icing. Grace Parker was skating after it. The linesman on the far side said no. And now RPI is going to send another, a tired group out to take this draw. Wrap back down low. And now cleared to center. Vogt. Christina Vogt will dump it in. Freshman from Arlington, Massachusetts. Now here is Papineau for RPI. Maddie Papineau trying to find the puck. It's gloved down by Shaughnessy as RPI couldn't clear again. Shaughnessy shot. That one goes wide. Kept it at the blue line by Ellie Larson. Erbinova's over there. She tries to force it out but can't clear. Into the slot. There's another shot blocked, and RPI will try the near side. Can't clear the zone. Kept in by Shaughnessy. Wrap it around. Loose puck. Terriers keep it alive. Good breakup there. Now Peterson will try and clear it off the glass. Ahead for Blitz. And finally, at least to the BU blue line, RPI gets the puck. Erbinova. Czech Republic national teamer works it back for Weiss. Back to Erbinova. Throws it down the middle for no one in particular. That's going to be a shot on goal for Erbinova. No, a shot! They score! It's Buckvik with the tally. Her second of the year. And after RPI weathers a storm like no other, they're the first ones to tally in this game. It was a harmless play. It was a dump-in for Erbinova. A little bit surprised that Kelly Shanahan didn't cover it. And RPI gets on the board with 5:14 to play in the first. I think it's only their second shot of the game. Erbinova must have had the first, and that must have been the second. I don't remember the puck being down there for more than an instance. Wrist shot coming, save made. Rampato saw it all the way. Andy Calderoni with that effort. So 5:14 was the goal. Now we get a stoppage here, and we're going to clean some. It's been that long. Wow, this is the 10-minute ice resurfacing coming at 4:55 of the period. That says something about how long RPI was hemmed in their own end. As we'll be back with more from the Houston Fieldhouse. Face-off coming up in the RPI zone. 4:55 to play in period number one. Mara Wagner there, see chatting it up with Emma Woolrath. Wagner is a transfer from Robert Morris after, unfortunately, that program went under on both the men's and women's sides. But the engineers are happy to have Mara on the squad. She's already produced a number of points this year, 6 points in six games, in fact, for RPI. 3 goals, 3 assists. And she's anchoring the top line for RPI. Not listed that way, but the most productive line for RPI this season, along with Lauren Severson and Rihanna Janke. As a shot comes in wide there from Wagner. Flip back to center ice, a chance maybe to break here. Fed on goal, kicked away by Rampato. As that was just Michaels trying to create a rebound in front. Now a loose puck in the high slot. And gathered up there by Wagner. Cross ice feed, but there's nobody over there. She might have seen one of the red and white BU sweaters and thrown it that direction, or maybe just throwing it to an open wing. I'm not sure. There's a lot of red and white on the ice right now. If not for the red shoulders on the RPI uniforms, this would be a completely red affair and would screw things up for the colorblind out there like myself. Fed up ice, it's a good find. Parker, could be a 2-on-1. Knocked away momentarily by Dalby. Shot comes in, they score. Good speed up ice, and BU scores on the rush. It's Courtney Correa, the senior from Whitby, Ontario, with her 5th goal of the year, making it 1-1. Another look at that play. Dalby got her stick on it, but just good strength on the puck here. And by the time Correa shot it, she was already within, I don't know, 8 feet of the goal. And tough for any goaltender to react and make a save on that play. So a real good goal to tie things up here. Yeah, it looks like they're offside, and they are. 3:25 to play in the period. Engineers were frustrating the Terriers for a few minutes, and then they scored their game's first goal, and that really had to maybe tick them off a little bit, but they were able to come back and score. Dumped in by Phillip. RPI will chase. Buckvik, the goal scorer, trying to track it down. Phillip's there as well. Phillip in the corner. Two players go down. Looked like incidental contact. Capel trying to dig it out for RPI. Takes a shot that goes wide. And now fed up the wall all the way down. This is going to be icing on RPI. Don't look at the goal. Little toe drag there from Korea. And Rimpano, like I said, you get a forward bearing down on you like that, you got to rely on your positioning there. There's a puck pinballing around. It gets thrown through the crease and to the other side. That was Nearest trying to stick handle their way in. Now a shot comes in from Shaughnessy. That's kicked away. Back to the blue line. Larson. Shaughnessy snapping around the zone. Down low off the post. She had the whole net to shoot at Nearest and put it wide somehow. A well-worked play there for the Terriers, and Nearest just couldn't stick it home. She has 3 goals already this year. And I don't think any would have been easier than that if it went in. Papineau. Chopped off her stick, trying to turn things around in a hurry, but Alexis dump it in, Nearest wanting to get a change. Rampano can't really slow it down, but it's fed to center by Erbinova. Severson gets it back. Lauren Severson on the move. Looking for a lane, goes to both knees, gets back up and stays on the puck. Good stick handling there by Lauren Severson, the grad student from Rockford, Illinois. As this is BU icing the puck. And we get a stoppage here. Broken up in the attacking zone. Good forecheck by Kaiser. Now it's fed down low. Kaiser back to the point. Dalby, wrist shot. Looking for the redirect. They get one. It was tipped on goal. I think that was Janky. No, that was Lily Friis Hansen with the redirect. It was a good work, well-worked play that time for the engineers. Friis Hansen just steering it on goal. But Callie Shanahan made the stop. Now a long shot by Price, and that goes just wide. Kept in by the pinch of Larson. Phillip drops it back to Price again. Long shot turned away. Larson had that one stopped. And now worked ahead. Oh, good play there at the blue line by Janky. RPI will go backwards with it to Price. Thrown cross ice for Larson, and that's going to be trouble. This BU forward grouping can really fly, and they break it up there. Trying to go short up high, short side. That was Parker. Missed the net. Now back comes Wagner, poked off her stick. Engineers have to go offense to defense here. It's a 3-on-2. Parker will take a long shot. Easy stick save that time for Rampato. And that'll do it for the period. 1-1 your score after one. As unofficially I have 29 shots for BU in that first period, 9 for RPI. We'll have the full totals for you as we come out of the break. Second period of action coming up in a few minutes. Your score once again after one. It is Boston University 1 and the Engineers 1. You're watching RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN. Welcome back inside the Houston Fieldhouse. We have women's hockey. It's non-league action. Boston University out of Hockey East. And the Engineers, of course. The homestanding Engineers from ECAC Hockey. 1-1 after one period of play. The stats tell a bit of a different story. Shots in the period were 15-2. Terriers. But RPI got the first goal of the game at 14:46. Sarah Buckbaker, second of the year. From Magdalena Erbitova and Delaney Weiss. But at 16:21, BU tied it up. Courtney Correa with her team-leading fifth goal of the year. Assist to McKenna Parker and Madison Cardason. Saves in that first period. One for Shanahan, 14 for Amanda Rampato. Faceoffs went to the Terriers by an 11-6 margin. Courtney Correa was 5-1 on the draw. And Catherine Fulham, I'll get that right eventually, was 4-2. RPI's top faceoff center was Lily Friis-Hansen, at 50%, 2-2. So we're ready to start the second period. Engineers played a bit of rope-a-dope in that opening frame after taking it on the chin as far as territorially and shots. They went and bagged the first goal of the game. We'll see if how they do fare maybe a little bit better as far as possession in the second period, but it's not a bad way to go about it. Now, Miranda Jenke going to hunker down and get chances off the rush. They scored a number of goals off the rush. They scored 9 goals against Union last two Saturdays ago. Now they go on the attack here. Centering pass cut off well by Calderoni. Loose puck in the crease. It'll be covered up. I looked down for a half second. I thought Calderoni had it. She did not. And it fell to Shanahan. Face off in the BU zone. We're early on in the second. Fanning on it there was Phillip. She had a crack at it. Now moved ahead by Price. This will wrap around. And it'll be carried out by Correa. She has the BU goal today. Gets it deep and goes down. Price comes over to sweep it aside into the corner. She's double teamed. It'll be one-handed to center by Buckvik. Thrown cross ice off the stick of Phillip. She gains speed into the zone. Good speed here by Phillip. Driving the net. Throws it in front off the stick. Rebound comes free and Capel. I don't know if she didn't see it or couldn't find it. And she had a pretty good chance to try and steer one on goal there. Didn't get anything on the puck. Back comes Blitz and the Engineers. Up ahead for Papineau. Maddie Papineau throws it back towards Weiss. She pinches in. Behind the goal it goes. This is much better from RPI than in the first period. They're at least challenging for some in-zone time here. It was probably close to 90-10 as far as offensive zone time for BU in the first. But the puck's been already down at this end more than it was seemingly in the whole first period combined. Good tie-up here by Papineau. Engineers changing behind her. Kaiser steps in. Kaiser shooting rebound. Shot comes in. And it's loose in the crease. Still not in. They score! Ellie Kaiser, first collegiate goal, and the Engineers take the lead. That play kept alive by McCutcheon. She's surely going to get an assist here. And the forecheck pays off for RPI as they retake the lead. Former Chicago Mission Ellie Kaiser. She started the play on the forecheck. She broke it up behind the goal, and it pays off for in the end. She's able to bury it. RPI back in front. Urbinovo goes across to Dalby. See if this can invigorate the Engineers more. They really scored on their only chance of the first period they scored on. But already an early opportunity here, and they bury that as well here in the second. Back comes BU. Shot was blocked in front. I think it was Urbinova. Now breaking down the middle. Here comes Wagner. Throwing it in front. A try there, and it's covered, I think. Maybe. McCutcheon was on the rush there with Mara Wagner, and Wagner shaking her head. She nearly had another there. Engineers look like they've been shot out of a cannon here in the second period. Face-off win. Larson, long shot, on goal, save Callahan. And the rebound is found and shot again. It's blocked and kicked to the line. Kept in again by RPI. And it's gloved down and carried out by Calderoni, poked ahead the other way, and off a skate back into BU territory. Mativi. Here is Severson on an intercept, trying to throw it in front for Papineau. That's broken up by Calderoni. dug out of the corner by Peterson. Brianna Jenke's there. She tried to throw it back to the point, but it's picked off and carried back by Neeris. Neeris, the 5'9 winger, gets it deep with BU changing behind the play. RPI gives it away, but Peterson does a nice job there covering the middle of the ice, as you expect your center to do. And breaks up a potential scoring chance there for the Terriers. Korea near side, chipped in deep by Lacey Martin, sophomore from Minnetonka, Minnesota. Back comes Blitz for RPI. Quickly met there by Martin. And turned around here by Alex Allen, senior from Abbotsford, British Columbia. And this is going to be icing on BU. Shots in the period. Are 5-0 RPI. That was quick math by me. 6-0. That wasn't even good quick math. Korea trying to get there. Nice play there by Buckvik to break it up. Still Sarah Buckvik. Puck just Velcroed to her. As it pops back out to center. Carried on by Parker. McKenna Parker trying to turn the corner on Dalby. And Dalby stays with her well. Now Tegan has her pinned up in the corner. Capel trying to help out. Or Buckvik, rather. Work to the blue line. Some room. Shaughnessy, a shot. Hit a boot. Might have hit Urbinova. Right back down low it goes. Magdalena picks it up for the Engineers, trying to one-hand it out of the zone and gets it as far as center. Still Urbinova. Hands it off to Capel. Capel, a long shot. That's blocked by Larson. And again, RPI, they've been successful. Their forechecks created some chances that created the goal. And it's this line that did it. Kaiser poking at it. Pops in the air. Trying to clear it out. And it does come to center. Murphy goes D to D to Larson. Taylor Larson scooping it in. Back to picking up Ellie Larson for BU. And again, they'll start over with Shaughnessy. She's pressured by Kaiser. And now it's shot all the way down. This should be icing again if RPI can get there, and they do. Good speed by Hannah Price, beating Michaels to her own end. 14:09 to play in the second. Hard to believe it, but it's been all RPI here in the second period. Almost a different team coming out of the locker room. It's almost like Coach Vines went in and said, stop playing against the name on the front of that jersey. Here's Severson trying to center. Jenke was in there but couldn't find her. Now Severson keeps it alive with a good stick lift. Fed to the middle, nobody home but Shaughnessy. And Julia Shaughnessy will work it to the near side where it's kept in by Urbinova. Severson, nifty move out of the corner, takes a shot and a glove save by Shanahan. But again, it's more from these Engineers here. Here's Blitz, fanned on the shot, trying to kick it to herself, throws it on goal, it's kicked away. Just getting a toe on it was Shanahan. Calderoni tries the near side. Mativi, center ice, knocked down by Peterson. She gets upended, penalty coming up here on the Terriers. Interference as Peterson was just dumped, didn't have the puck. Peterson did a nice job to break it up. Probably was more of a trip than interference, but what are you going to do? There was a penalty either way. Phelem in the box. Second power play chance for RPI. They're 0-for-1. They didn't have a shot on their first power play.
Washington University.
Long shot here, blocked by traffic. It was Urbinova trying to keep it in at the line. She cannot. It's back out to center. Now, Urbinova is going to be the first one to it, as Papineau was just kind of watching from the middle of the ice. Bit of a dangerous pass, but it comes through. Now Janky loses it. Wuthrich had it for a moment, but wants to get a change and just dumps it in. Brianna Janky sent cross ice again, and again it's a stick in the way. Larson loses it. Short-handed in front. Good back check there by Papineau. And the Engineers' power play has not gotten going yet in either opportunity. Just this forecheck on the PK has been tough to solve so far for the Engineers. They'll try to break out far side now. Taking a whack there was McCutcheon. Does get it into the zone. Fed back to the blue line. Larson looks down low. Capel going to pick it up there. Michaela Capel, senior from Dawson's Creek, British Columbia. Back to blitz. McCutcheon fanned on the slapper. Goes down low for Capel again. Capel off the back of the net. Has to try and track it down. Kaiser going to try and find it. Capel as well. McCutcheon trying to cycle now. Finds Capel. Double team comes. Loose to Kaiser. Backhand in front. McCutcheon a drive and a save. Audrey McCutcheon stepped into one. Didn't really care where it went, it looked like, from that range. And the save was made by Shanahan. Caught her up high on the chest. 7 to go in the power play. So RPI finally able to settle things down to the man advantage. They get a good look on the try by McCutcheon. This will hop off Phillips' stick and in deep. Fed along by Cardesi. Towards the line and out. Erbinova has to backcheck here. Throws it cross ice. Misses Dalby, but she'll be the first one there. Tipped along to center. Outside the reach of Wagner. Or make it Peterson, rather. Got to be careful with that stick. She kind of caught the Fulham up high. Doesn't get called here. Shot deep. Callahan will stop it. Or Shanahan, excuse me. Played by Shaughnessy. Loose puck to center. Gathered up by Dalby. Fires it back in. Broken up there. And Allen will skate the other way for BU. Allen. Wrist shot wide. Caroms around. Now walking right in. A shot put wide by Allen. I don't think Rampato got a piece of that, but I could be wrong. Penalty coming up here. As a jam try in front gets tipped up into the netting and we get a stoppage. And looks like it's going to be a rough. You don't see a lot of roughing in women's hockey, but we got a call here. Who'd they get? Is it Urbinova? I guess. Urbinova off for roughing. Boarding, excuse me. I got my signals crossed there. I guess it was board, yes. I was going to say, any kind of check is illegal, so you could start there. But boarding is the call, 2-minute penalty. Power play for BU, down by a goal. They're 0-for-2 today. They had 4 shots on their first 2 power play tries in total. Wrapped deep by the Terriers. Picked up down low, Ursoy. Hands it off there to Neeris. Neeris looking for a passing lane. Fed up top as Capel got her stick to the puck but couldn't break up the play. Terriers work it down low looking for the backdoor feed. They're trying to find Cardesi all by herself but couldn't feed the pass through. Now it's given away. And Buckvick at the end of her penalty killing shift just dumps it in halfway through or thereabouts. RPI on top, 2-1. Just one shot in the period for BU. RPI has 9. After the Terriers outshot RPI 15-3 in the first. Puck behind the RPI goal. Korea. And now Parker, this is the top unit for BU. Up top, Calderoni across. Bativi, a shot and a save. Not going to beat Rampato from there. She can see it. And RPI did a good job clearing her sight lanes. Calderoni trying to throw it in front. There's a lot of traffic there, and RPI clears it down. Worked out by Mauro Wagner in the end. Former Robert Morris Colonial sent back out to center as BU got across the line initially. Now Mativi shoots it in. Taylor Larson for RPI, four to go on the power play. Broken up but kept in at the line. Long shot, save Rampato, no rebound. And the penalty is over. So the Engineers are 3-for-3 on the kill, facing a power play that had been fairly successful so far. And it's been all Hockey East play for the Terriers so far, so you can expect those power play goals are against stiff competition. No slouches on the schedule in Hockey East. Run down the scoring here in this game so far. RPI scoring at 14:46 of the first period. Sarah Buckvik from Magdalena Erbinova and Delaney Weiss. Here's another look at the long shot. This is important that Rampato holds this because you can see crashing the net there was Kaylee Donnelly, senior captain out of Wellesley, Mass. North American Hockey Academy, where she played her junior hockey. 40 career points in 89 games. This is the 90th career game for Kaylee Donnelly. And you got a feel for these seniors and the ones that came before them last year that didn't get a chance to play a senior season then, or had a shortened one. Their collegiate careers cut down due to COVID-19, but we're so happy to have hockey again here at the Houston Fieldhouse. Face off one back to the point. It's kept in by Allen. She had a glorious chance in this period joining the rush. Couldn't stick it home. And it's broken up at center by Allen. Martin chips it in. First one too. It's going to be Dalby for RPI. Rolling puck. Kaiser. She gets shoved a bit there. Knocks her off the puck. Gets it back, though, on the connection from Dalby. Chipped in deep. McCutcheon trying to get there. Four goals on the year for McCutcheon, including a hat trick against Union two Saturdays ago, helping the Engineers to a 9-2 victory. Here's McCutcheon again. Feeds it down low. Trying to jam it in front. That was Buckvik. Already has a goal tonight. A little bit of speed now for BU. Cardacey in the zone all by herself. Well, she's being helped out a bit there. A couple of teammates join the play just off the bench. Parker. Cardacey throws it in the middle. Buckvik picks it up there. And chops it to center. Phillip can't control. Gathered and turned around by Roberts. She lost it. Fed into the BU zone by Buckvik. And that's where the Terriers take over again. Correa. Collision at center. Penalty coming up here. I think they're going to get Capel, but she was just in the wrong place at the wrong time, it looked like. Phillip went sprawling over her back. I think they're going to make a decision here. Let's see. It was a dangerous play. I don't even know what the call was. Body checking, okay. Body checking is the call on Capel. Fourth power play for BU today. Face-off win here for BU. And they set things up again. This has been a good-looking power play for the Terriers so far. Just unsuccessful in the results department up to this point. Shaughnessy. Price chasing the puck around, but Terriers moving it faster. Shaughnessy. One time. Slap shot. Glove saved by Rampato. Rampato tracking the puck very well from her left to right. Sees that puck come in, gets the glove out and makes the stop on Shaughnessy, who already has 2 goals in 5 games this year from the blue line. It's Shaughnessy again. 6'1", Julia Shaughnessy. Can use that leverage to her advantage and really step into shots here, as you saw just there. Nearest, back to Shaughnessy, lost the puck. Buckvik trying to skate. Shorthanded, and at least will waste some time as he chops it into the zone. Couldn't quite turn on the jets there. Both her and Shaughnessy were at a standstill. And she couldn't quite break away. Puck forced behind the goal. Picked up there by Ersoy. And they tie up behind the net now. One-timer hits a leg. Erbinova got in the way of that, and it's cleared down by Lily Friis Hansen, the senior from Lyngby, Denmark. A couple assists already on the year for Lily. Both her and Erbinova went to Calgary for the World Championships this summer. Chopped off the glass, well kept at the line by Calderoni. 14 to go on the power play. Nadia Mativi. Dropping it back, Mativi fans on it, sent back to the blue line. Oh, loose puck, and forced out to center by Severson. Mativi's going to get there. That was Korea, excuse me, from the slot before that, who fanned on the shot. Shots are 19-12 BU, but the Engineers have had the advantage. If not for a couple of penalty kills here, RPI would be in better shape even in that department. Now, good play at the wall by Parker to keep things alive for BU in the offensive zone. Puck is underneath an Engineer, Alexander. Finally, RPA able to clear to center. Allen's going to shoot it back in, however. Rampato back to get it. I'm sure Amanda's happy for the reduced workload she's had to deal with here in this period, although they did have the 2 power plays. The shot totals not nearly what they were in the first. I'm sure she's thankful for that. Maddie Peterson will tie up now as RPI tries to go back on the attack for the first time in what seems like ages. Here's a long shot, hit a skate. Larson trying to, Kaiser trying to find it. And she gets dumped. And the puck's back the other way. Trying to make a move. Good defensive play there by Taylor Larson as she stands up. I think that was Larson the other way. Now a shot comes in wide. No, that was Wuthrich who led the rush the other way. Beg your pardon. Now it's dumped back by RPI. No icing here. 3:15 to play in the second. Stick handling through center is Ersoy. Make that Fulham. And now it's loose at center. Back comes RPI. Slap shot coming and a save. As that was Asia Taylor-Walters, the sophomore from Toronto, looking for her first point as a collegiate athlete and made a strong bid for it there. An absolute bomb off the shoulder of Shanahan. We'll look at the drive as Taylor-Walters got a lot on that. It was well held, though, with Papineau charging for RPI. Shanahan had to be good there, and she was. Dumped in by the Engineers, Tegan Dalby. Turned around by Shaughnessy. Fed off the skate of McCutcheon. And now picked up again by Shaughnessy. To the point where it's kept in by Dalby. Fed off the end wall. Comes off pretty hot, but Shaughnessy picks it up and carries it out of danger. To the line, gloved down by Erbinova. Gives it right to Shaughnessy. Cross ice feed and a chance to break. Bad change, RPI. Here comes BU. Slap shot coming, they score. Julia Nearest, her 4th of the year. And it ties the game at 2. I think RPI thought that Erbinova got that puck deep. She didn't. And then Rampato beaten clean on a slap shot from the circle. We're tied 2-2. It was well done by BU to recognize the situation and get that puck out of the zone quickly to Neeris. And she made no mistake about that. Back come the Engineers, 3-on-2. Wagner into the slot. Shot comes in. It trickles wide on the try by Severson. Wagner. Tie up in the corner.
Boston University goal was scored by number 16, Julian Harris. Assisted by number 20, Julian Johnson.
Now Martin.
17:38.
Korea goes behind. Too far for Calderoni. Parker dumps it in. Weiss shot up the boards, and Taylor Walters going to get there. Taylor Walters walking in and just missed wide, glove side. Puck goes behind the cage. Couple of good shifts now for Taylor Walters. Here's Larson down low, tip wide by Taylor Walters, and now thrown back the other way, all the way down. This is going to be icing, I think. And it is. 1:09 to go, second period. Shots are 20-14 BU, and the game is tied at 2. BU has already played in a couple of ties this year. Of course, the new 3-on-3 overtime rules in effect. Thrown into the middle, broken up. Buckvik was trying to redirect that, but I got too much of it and just sat there. As we're under a minute to go in the second. Dragged along by Parker. Allen stick handling through traffic. Carries on. Alex Allen trying to center. That's broken up. Chipped up the boards by Arbinova. And now racing to it is Capelle. Flips off the wall to herself. Met by a trio of Terriers and just dumps it in. Allen trying to get away from Phillip. And now all the way down the ice it goes. It was deflected, so no icing here. Good stick there by Rampato to break up the centering pass from behind the goal. As it's chipped off the wall and gathered up at center ice. That by Grace Parker. Good play at the blue line. Just shoveling it to center by Taylor Larson of RPI. Now back to pick it up is Parker, junior from Nepean, Ontario. That'll do it for the second period. 2-2 your score. It's been a great game here so far at the Houston Fieldhouse with RPI weathering an early storm to take a 2-1 lead, but BU got one back here in the second to make it all square. Shots 20-14 after the second. We'll head to the third. We'll have that for you coming up here, RPI TV and ESPN.
Thank you.
Third period about to get underway here, RPI and Boston University women's hockey on RPI TV and ESPN. Welcome you back inside the Houston Fieldhouse, where it is 2-2 after two periods of play. Shots are 20-14 in favor of BU after RPI outshot the Terriers 11-5 in the second. Scoring in the second period at 2:20 was Ellie Kaiser, her first collegiate goal, from Manny Papineau and Lily Fries-Hansen. And then at 17:38, it was Julian Neeris from Julia Shaughnessy at 17:38 of the second. That's where we stand, 2-2. RPI had a much better first half to the second period than they did to the second half. And they're looking to kind of regain that energy they had in the start of the second period, which led to that goal that they got. It all kind of culminated with that go-ahead goal. The Engineers have not trailed in this game. After being bombarded by shots early in the first period, they scored the game's first goal on their second shot of the game. As we were underway here in the third, then they really picked things up to start the second. Got the go-ahead goal, but BU, as I mentioned, tied it up. So we're 2-2. And third period's underway. Chipped into the RPI zone by Neeris. She has the most recent goal of the game. And now she'll pick one off in the slot. As it's tapped back to the corner, pinballs off a couple of sticks and finds itself in the corner again. Ersoy picked up by Wagner and turned up ice here by Rihanna Janke. Threw it off a skate. BU takes over there. This is Mativa, Nadia Mativa. Stolen away by Severson. She goes all the way back to her own blue line. And the pass too far for Price is going to be icing here on RPI. And we got our first whistle 50 seconds in. And then just a bit unfortunate that that group has to stay on the ice, although I think RPI already changed. Yeah, that's not the group that started the period, I don't think. There's Rihanna Janke. Her sister Mika not in the lineup tonight. They're both from Dallas, Texas. Or Allen, Texas, excuse me. Played for the Dallas Stars. Junior level. Here's Allen. Snapped across. Cardacy thought about a slap shot. Takes one and goes way wide. Karam's all the way around. Allen is all the way up ice, almost below the dot, but does corral it and shoot it back in. Have to be a good skater to be able to pinch that high. As a blue liner. Bouncing puck at neutral ice. Carried along there by Roberts. It's been a much more even game since that first period in which RPI was outshot 15-3. Spun to the ice was Correa, and now we get a penalty. And it's going to be boarding. It wasn't for when Correa got spilled. It was a separate play. They're going to get Buckvik here. And this is a fifth power play here for Boston University, and you are really playing with fire if you're RPI. Your penalty kill's been good all year. I say all year, it's only been six games. And it's been good today as far as keeping the puck out of the net, but you just can't keep making tracks to the box. BU's 0-for-4 on the power play. They have six power play shots, and each time they've had a man advantage, they've really been able to set things up quickly and been pretty efficient moving it around. Now, to RPI's credit, they haven't obviously don't have a goal, and they haven't created too many grade-A scoring chances. The six shots have primarily been from the outside, and RPI has done a good job of cleaning up the middle. So maybe that's the plan from the start for RPI, to let the Terriers have the outside and just make sure they don't have anything up close. Correa shot off the base of the net. Tries to walk it out in front. It's poked away by Rampato, trying to clear near side where it is kept in. Calderoni down low. Tie-up was Parker. RPI trying to clear it down the middle, and they do. Delaney Weiss with a nice play. Haven't said a lot about Delaney, but she's been a solid blue liner. She missed a whole year due to injury a few years ago. So she's a senior from Lake Forest, Illinois, with only 39 career games played. But does have 7 points, a goal, and six assists in her career. Picked up her first career goal, I think, earlier this year. 46 to go on the power play for BU. Severson, chance to look up. Ice, she'll lob it ahead. Wagner wants to skate shorthanded. And shielded away. The last one back there, was, I think, is Neeris. So no defenseman to be found, but Neeris back checking. Collects the puck. Now Severson can't clear. Second effort gets the job done. That was Larson. Of course, Larson and the rest of the RPI sophomore class had to wait a whole year to play collegiate hockey. I'm sure they are glad to be doing so now and playing at a pretty high level, all things considered, based on where the Engineers left off in 29-20. So out of the box, 2019-20, out of the box is Buckvik. Engineers kill it off. They're 4-for-4 on the kill. As losing an edge and going down, there's a big old pile up there on far side of the ice, but really only benefits the Engineers. That was gloved down. Mativa, not out of the woods yet. Shot blocked by Dolby up into the netting. That was a giveaway. You can't be doing that in the defensive zone. Four minutes gone here in the third. Faceoff win for the Terriers. Just slap it to the half boards. And Julia Blitz going to try and carry to center. Glove down. That's going to be a hand pass. An obvious one. As that was Andy Calderoni, the sophomore from Kirkland, Quebec. 3 assists in 5 games this year. She just swatted that one out of the air with her glove. That's textbook. Referee had to make the call on the far side. That being Michael St. Lawrence. So 5 power plays in the game for BU, just 2 for RPI. Not too far off from what you'd expect with how the balance of play has been for the most part. Engineers caught being a little too physical. There was a pretty questionable interference call on Taylor Larson earlier, but other than that, it's been pretty by the book. Nice move there. It's Ellie Kaiser from center ice. She'll shoot it in. Ends up on goal. This will hop up in the air, but not leave the playing surface. Kept alive by Fries Hansen momentarily. Kaiser loops it, lobs it down low. Cardacy will try the far side again. Madison Michaels to the line where it's kept in. Fed across, Larson into the middle. She's looking for Fries Hansen. Looks like she pulled her stick away. Maybe thought that was intended for somebody else, but I don't think it was. Now Fries Hansen's pinned up in the corner by Correa. Pinching is Larson. And McCutcheon can't keep it in the zone. Fries Hansen back to support Larson there at the blue line, or in her defensive spot anyway. Now Donnelly. Stick handling is Kaiser. Backhand shovel pass ahead for McCutcheon. McCutcheon takes a look, works it up the wall. Here's Wagner. Wagner stops at the half wall, waiting for help. Hand off Janky. Janky walking right in. Janky turning, couldn't get the shot away. Long shot here, and a save by Shanahan, and she holds on with the glove. As the Engineers look dangerous there, as Zerbinova, she has a hard shot. That was just a wrister. But again, another step being taken here by these Engineers. Almost on a period-by-period level. Face-off win for RPI as Janky's tied up. It gets kicked down low by Grace Parker. And they try to walk it out in front, but that's broken up. Now it's McKenna Parker for BU. Connection through the middle for Brooke Ursoy. Ursoy runs into Erbinova. Erbinova goes down, but the puck is lifted along, and Dolby has a chance to clear and just throws it out to center ice for Shaughnessy's there. It's been a pretty well-played game, all things considered. And there's a bit of a dangerous pass there, and now they're offside, as Shaughnessy brought it in before McKenna Parker could step back into the neutral zone. It's been a very well played game. You often wonder, RPI's gone 2 weeks without playing, against anybody else after their off weekend. How sharp are you going to be? And they weren't sharp in the first period, but they've quickly regained, I think, that mojo they had against Union a couple weeks ago. Just playing more confidently. It was really the difference between what we saw against the Dutch women and what Arpe was able to put onto the ice 2 years ago as Capel throws this into the middle. Loose puck shot coming. That's blocked. A good try there by Capel. And now it's back out to center. Or Buckvik, excuse me. Off the stick of Taylor Walters and turned back around by BU. In the slot. Shot comes in. Blocker save. And the rebound pops away. Far enough away to not cause problems. Now back comes Taylor Walters all by herself. Asia Taylor Walters waits for reinforcements as RPI changes. It'll be carried back the other way by Neeris. She'll slide it down low and get a change herself. Papineau into the middle for Peterson. Maddie Peterson picked up her first goal of the season against Union a couple weeks ago. Junior from Princeton, Minnesota is Peterson. She was relied on heavily 2 years ago. Now she's playing on the fourth line, and not to say she's a fourth line player. She certainly isn't. She's a veteran on this team now. But just showing the depth that RPI has, they can roll all four lines and be pretty confident what they're putting on the ice. And that's something that Coach Bynes has to be happy with. Here comes Parker now for BU. Short angle shot off the post. McKenna Parker rings the iron. Parker again trying to center, comes all the way through. Correa shot, and that one goes wide. Another try saved by Rampano. BU knocking on the door right now. As back to the point, it's Correa. A little toe drag here, puck in the middle, picked up McCutchen. RPI could certainly use a whistle. McCutchen's going to try and skate this one out. Chop back into the RPI zone. Parker fed it wide. It might have been a pass for Correa. I'm not sure, but finally the puck leaves the zone. Engineers are going to try and change a couple here, but they can't do too much because back comes BU. Little give and go. Looking for Shaughnessy. That doesn't work out. Correa again. Shaughnessy. Snapped it back towards her. Good stick there defensively. That was Jenke. And Mativi's pass goes behind the goal. Parker, it's been a very long shift for her. This group wants to attack. Here's a shot. Save Rampano. And there's the whistle RPI needed. 10:09 to play in the third. Still tied at two. We'll give a shout out to RPI Field Hockey with a big win today on the road against William Smith. Trying to lock up a playoff spot would be impressive after the Engineers went winless 2 years ago. RPI on the ice here. The ice hockey team trying to have similar success in a rebound season here in 2021-22. And the way they played against Union, you have to think good things are coming. They played well today as well, no matter how this one ends up. Tegan Dalby. They've only given up 8 shots since the first period. Long shot here, that's blocked. Thrown in front through everybody. Slap shot coming, saved by Rampano on the pad. Andy Calderoni lined one up from the top of the circle. Rampano made the stop. She continues to be a solid backbone of this RPI team defensively, Rampano. Junior from Stony Creek, Ontario. Had no wins through her first season here at RPI 2 years ago, but you couldn't tell by her demeanor. That's what you need from a goalie. Phillip trying to track it down. Wuthrich had it. Now it's thrown deep. No icing here as it was tipped in. MJ Alexander will backhand it around. Delaney Weiss trying to get there. She's met by Martin. And Lacey Martin digging away, as is Kaylee Donnelly. Worked ahead, good connection. Michaela Capel, center ice, dumping it in. Everything gets magnified here, every play, as you get down to the final stages of a tie game. And here's a good outlet pass. Toe drag, shot wide. That was Allen. She's looked to shoot the puck on a number of occasions today. She only has 2 career goals in 90 games. This is a puck out of play, I think. I look down for a second, of course. Something happens. Yeah, it's out of play. BU is in the middle of a change. I think the puck went into their bench. Shots are 24-17 now, Boston University, in a 2-2 game. And I think now we get our media stoppage here. We'll step aside. 8:12 to go in this one. We got a good one going. It's 2-2 RPI and Boston University. Twelve to go, third period. We're 5 aside as the puck is dropped at center after we get a puck over the bench situation. Into the bench. Tipped along by Papineau out of the zone. Maddie Papineau, mentioned playing in her 3rd game of the year. Hannah Price zings it off the wall. This is going to be icing. And we'll draw it up in the RPI
and
zone.
The action this afternoon, final score, RPI 2, William Smith 0.
RPI in action tomorrow against number 9 Providence right here at the Houston Fieldhouse. You can watch that one live on RPI TV and ESPN+. BU heads over to Union. Take on the Dutchwoman. Now a chance for a 2-on-1. Blitz quickly across where Papineau is broken up. I think they're offside now. Yes, they are. A little bit early pass there for Blitz. I think it was telegraphed just a little bit. She was trying to throw it across to Maddie Papineau. Those chances can come because the Terriers like to throw their D into the attack here. They're not afraid to do so. It's very aggressive style of offense, but it can turn into opportunities like the Engineers almost just had there, as Friis Hansen got tangled up with the Terrier in the corner there. Fanning on the pass was Phelim. Now a long shot blocked by Erbanova. Shot comes in, is hammered wide. Thrown right through the crease and picked up on the other side. Back come the Engineers, McCutcheon, and they're offside. Face-off win for the Terriers. Nadia Mativi goes across, tipped into the zone. And by Martin, and they chase. Picked up by Phillip. She gets it as far as center, where it's turned back around. Mativi dumping in. Rampato out of her net, going to lift it along. Good play defensively there by the Engineers. That was Buckvik. Now Phillip lost an edge, or she might have had a chance there if Kelder only lost it for a second. Back comes Donnelly. Flips it past Alexander. Weiss chipping off the boards. Pinching again is Mativi. Steps around Weiss. Still Mativi on it. Dug out by RPI. Capel throws her body into it. Six to go in the third. Donnelly. Handed off for Mativi. Tried a toe drag. Fired to center. Good connection. Brianna Jenke. Trying to move into the zone. And she's not against going after people on the stick handle. She'll try to make a move for sure. Will Rihanna Jenke. Not afraid of anybody, I guess I was trying to say. Not afraid of making that move. It's okay to make it at the attacking blue line. You just don't want to make it before that. And I guess it depends if you're trying to get new skaters on the ice. Anyway, here comes Correa trying to center on the backhand. Defended well that time by Larson. Knocked out of the air by Jenke. She is very shifty. She has 3 goals this year. Jenke does. And an assist. Ahead from Blitz, just dumping it in. As we approach 5 minutes to go in the third. The 2-2 game, broken up there by Peterson. Terriers touch up, but the Engineers have it. Tegan Dalby, junior from Burlington, Ontario. Good connection ahead. Blitz trying to take a shot, eventually gets it off, and then she gets dumped and goes behind the goal. But it seems as though they're letting him play on both sides of the puck here. Which you like to see. You don't like to see the tic-tac body checking calls in women's hockey. Nah, it was not a lot in that. I think she just lost an edge, to be honest. Shot in from Blitz, and there's a save. Chipped off the dasher, picked up by Peterson. She'll go back to Dalby. Dalby crosses the red line and just dumps it in. It was headed wide of goal. Turned around by the Terriers. It'll be picked up here by Kaiser. Engineers trying to spark something here. Kaiser centering pass all the way through, looking for Friis Hansen. Starts the break the other way. Nearest into the zone. Gets stood up there by Alexander. That was actually more interference than the one they called in the first period. Back comes the Engineers. Kaiser feeding into the middle. Tough handle. It was behind McCutcheon. She still tried to take a whack at it. Back to the blue line. Weiss on her backhand. Lobs it into the air. It'll go behind the goal. Shaughnessy. Stick handling away from McCutcheon. Picking up speed. It's Shaughnessy all by herself. Pulls up at the line. She's tied up there. Donnelly now. Drop pass. Picked up by Martin. Tight angle shot. Save made by Rampano, and she holds on. Little bit of traffic in front, but that's not going to trouble Rampano on too many occasions. Shots are 25-19, BU. Face-off just sits on the dot. Finally picked away. Mativi's long shot deflects over the top. Now Larson into the skates of Price, and it's chipped towards the line but not out. Capel couldn't clear. Price will go behind. Larson, good connection. Phillip trying to move it ahead. She stood up at the blue line by Mativi. That's just a big-time play by a veteran blue liner. RPI stays on it. Capella drive! Oh, a glove save! Shanahan, as that one was labeled for the top right corner. Michaela Capel trying to change the score line here. She nearly did, if not for the glove of Callie Shanahan. Nice move by Arbinova to get away from the forechecker behind the goal, then runs into more trouble. Fed across behind Severson. Penalty coming up, and it's going to go on the Terriers with 2:32 to go. What a time for a penalty here in the offensive zone. It's going to be a trip. And they got McKenna Parker. See if we can see it. That's a tough play for Parker because the puck is there, right? She's going for the puck, but gets her stick caught in the skates of Erbinova. Now we get a timeout here. And a timeout by Coach Vines and the engineers, maybe just trying to settle some things down here. This is only your third power play of the game. The first one was pretty non-eventful. They got a decent look in the second power play chance when they got to, as McCutcheon got free in the slot. Took a slap shot, and remember, was saved by Shanahan, of course. Injures 0 for 2 on the man advantage. Just one shot, that was the one I mentioned. But a lot of times the games, they come down to special teams. And BU 0 for 5 on the power play. RPI 0 for 2. If they can convert here, it would almost certainly be a game deciding tally. RPI, as I mentioned, came into play with the 2 power play goals and 15 tries. They're now 2 out of 17 on the year. They'll send out Severson, Janky, Erbinova, Blitz, and Wagner. It's just one defenseman, and that's Erbinova. Here's your draw. Engineers win it. Severson picks it out of the pile. She'll now hand it off. Janky up top. Erbinova. Back up top, Erbinova. Blitz. Erbinova. High pressure there from Blinkhorn. We haven't seen a lot of her today. Erbinova. Feeds it back up top. Long shot, hit a shin pad. That was Blitz with the try. As we're down to 2 minutes to go in regulation. Engineers have established possession on this power play early. Blitz, a shot, looking for the tip in front. Severson tried to get there. And they keep it alive. Erbinova fed into the slot. Loose puck, Severson put it wide. Back up top they go. Blitz, a drive. That's a stop there by Shanahan, but she saw it all the way. Loose puck, Janky trying to tie up in the corner there before reinforcements can come help out. Severson trying to push it back to the point. Now she'll try and tie up. Severson looks shaken up. Still on the attack, it's Blitz. Wrist shot, she scores! It's a power play goal for Julia Blitz, and the Engineers take a 3-2 lead. Second of the year for Blitz, and the fourth of her career. The Engineers do capitalize on the power play. They're now 1-for-3. They have Blitz at the blue line on this power play for a reason. She has a great shot. She showed it off there. And Shanahan just couldn't get to it. So now 1:07. Keep an eye on Shanahan for you. Shaughnessy behind the net. Capel trying to dig away. BU floats one out to center. Price going to chase. There goes the netminder. Off with 48 seconds. She's having trouble getting off the ice. The forward is on anyway. There's too many men on the ice right now. Finally, the goalie's off. A long shot that's blocked by a skate. Flipped out to center, Mativi. 25 to go. Wuthrich gets it back. Back up top, some room. Far side, one-time drive, saved by Rampato. Shaughnessy stepped into that one. And Rampato made the right pad stop. 9 to go. Price to center, loose puck, Capel with 6. With 3. And it's going to be an empty net goal with 0.6 seconds left. Michaela Capel ices it here. She's exhausted. The Engineers certainly didn't need an empty net goal, but it sure feels good. And when you're that close to the net, you might as well stick it home. Second goal of the season for Capel, the fourth of her collegiate career. And the senior from Dawson Creek, B.C., makes it 4-2. RPI fans get to go home happy here. It's a big win for RPI. It's a three-game winning streak for the Engineers, their first since September of 2017. And I bet it feels good for every one of those players in that scrum.
RPI's third goal was scored by number 21, Julian Blitz. She was assisted.
What a finish to this game. My goodness, RPI picks up the win. Engineers improved to 3-4 on the year. And they hand BU their first loss of the season. The Terriers are now 3-1-2. For all of our RPI TV crew here at the Houston Fieldhouse, always doing such a great job. Myself, Perry Lascaris, we thank you for watching tonight's game. Once again, your final score from Troy. It was the Engineers 4 and the BU Terriers 2. This has been RPI Hockey on RPI TV and ESPN.